Things look mighty different ever since the flood. Now there's water everywhere. And where there's not, there's mud. I still remember how it was when Noah built the ark. The grass was green and the trees were tall. Just right for a small aardvark. We romped through all the foliage and played among the ferns. We didn't seem to have a care. Only man had need to learn. For man had grown so wicked, forgetting God's command. Except for Noah's family, violence filled the land. All seemed restless the day the Lord appeared. We heard him speak to Noah, calming all that we had feared. From aardvarks down to zebras, we all were quickly told that Noah was to build an ark, and animals it would hold. Began to help him, a job we did not dread. If you didn't have a hand, you could lend a trunk instead. An aardvark cannot lift much. We're not too good with tools, but we can check for termites. We like those pesky fools. Building the ark wasn't easy. We needed so much wood, Noah's sons would go to the forest and cut down what they could. The wood was cut and shaped and then made into mighty beams. The rhinos pulled them into place and pitch filled in the seams. The people watched in wonder the spectacle to see. Some of them would help us, while others laughed with glee. It seemed to be so silly that men could not conceive that God would send a mighty flood. But they would not believe. Been told by God to pack up what he'd need. And so he took along some food, his tools, his books, and seed. He told his wife to pack her things and went to see his son, for since the ark was finished, the loading had begun. Then God called all his creatures to come from far and near while Noah gave instructions and we all took time to hear. For God had wisely chosen a pair of every kind, and some he chose by sevens. He did not change his mind. When finally all was ready, Noah made his final plea. He told about the rain to come, and he begged his friends to see. Some of them stopped to listen, while others closed their ears. It seemed they had no time for God. Poor Noah was in tears. And then God called his creatures to come into the ark. Naturally, the procession was led by this aardvark. Then Noah and his family placed their things upon the floor, and when we all were safe inside, 'twas then God shut the door. Fell from heaven, beat down upon the roof, and the flashes of lightning thundered like the beating of a hoof. As Noah talked with the animals and calmed those on the boat, the waters of the flood rose up and caused the ark to float. The waters of the flood were such they tossed the ark about. But we all slept aboard securely. There was no need to pout. And God took care of all our needs, for we were safe inside. The waters covered all the earth. There was no place to hide. And when the flood was over, the ark came to a stop. We landed on Mount Ararat, up high and near the top. The dove brought back an olive branch, so that is how we knew that it was time to leave the ark, because the flood was through. Yes, things look mighty different without the pretty trees. But God said they will grow again. It is his will to please. The men, with all their evil thoughts, had all been washed away. I hope that you remember this and live for God each day.